What's going on, TTC? Bama Tony 73 coming at you from Birmingham, Alabama. Roll Tide, roll. As you see, I have a special guest with me here today. It's Coach Nick Saban. What's going on, TTC? Bama Tony 73 coming at you from Birmingham, Alabama on a rainy, nasty-ass day out here today. It's not going to get any better. It's quit for the moment, but it's supposed to get worse tomorrow all day long. But Alabama come out of Starkville with a win. It wasn't very impressive to me, but hey, it's a W, and I'll take it all day long. A.J. McCarron needs to quit overthrowing receivers, and he's throwing into traffic of receivers that are covered. You know, he needs to work on that. He's had the time in the pocket. He's got receivers over here waving at him, you know, wide open, and he just needs to take his time a little bit more and make the best pass. But other than that, he has done a great job as a first-year starter, and I don't believe any of us can complain about that. But, hey, Oregon got the win over Stanford. I was happy to see that. But that only got Oregon back up into the national championship talk again, of course. There's still a lot that can happen with these final two games. You know, if Arkansas happens to beat LSU, then that's going to force the three-way tie situation with Alabama, LSU, and Arkansas, which Alabama will take that. And if Arkansas happens to beat LSU, they would move up to number four. They would not jump us, considering that we've already beat Arkansas by 24 points. And then LSU would take Arkansas' spot. They would drop from number one to number six, I'm thinking, because Alabama has we only lost to them by a field goal in OT. So they would probably go to, I'm thinking, maybe five or six at least. But Oregon got the win. All we need now is Oklahoma State to bite the dust to Oklahoma, and I'm really pulling for you, Oklahoma Sooners. December 3rd, Sooner Sun 2, and Oni Kuno. That's really about all the Oklahoma Sooner fans that I know on YouTube, but I hope y'all take them. But we have two games remaining here. We have Georgia Southern and the game. The one game that all Alabama and Auburn fans wait for each year. And it is the Iron Bowl, baby. And I'm really liking our chances in this Iron Bowl. Auburn's young defense going up against Trent Richardson and Eddie Lacy and possibly Jalston Fowler. It's going to be very difficult for them. And I see us getting out with a pretty good win. Let's just see what the Alabama Magic 8-Ball has to say about it. Because we know it's always right. So we'll see what it has to say. Alabama Magic 8-Ball. Will the Alabama Crimson Tide go down to Auburn, Alabama and beat the Auburn Tigers in this year's Iron Bowl in Jordan-Hare Stadium? Answer unclear. Ask later. Well, I don't have later, so let's go ahead and do it. Alabama Magic 8-Ball, will the Alabama Crimson Tide go down to Jordan-Hare Stadium in Auburn, Alabama and beat the Auburn Tigers this year? Well, there you have it. Absolutely. Absolutely, baby. But there's still a lot with these two remaining games that can happen. I mean, if LSU happens to win out, we just need Oklahoma State to lose, and I don't think they're going to jump Oregon over us. I don't see that happening. We'll just have to win out. That's the most important thing right now. There's still a lot that can happen here, so we just have to hope for the best. I guess this is going to be my Alabama Auburn Iron Bowl video because there's not really any Auburn fans on YouTube that I'm aware of that do videos to have a hate week with. So there's not going to really be a whole lot of spewing hate at Auburn this season, it doesn't appear. So that's all right. I just want to win out, you know, and I'll come back and do a post video on it. But as far as these last two games, now I'm going to take Bama 41, Georgia Southern 7. And just stay tuned to the end of the video, please, and see what my prediction is for the Iron Bowl. I think we'll take it. And as you saw, the Alabama Magic 8-ball and pretty much confirmed it. So, but hey, we'll just have to see how it plays out. We still have a shot for New Orleans, but Bama fans, if we don't happen to get in there in that number 2 spot and stay there, you know, it's hard to complain about a BCS bowl, whether it's a Fiesta, Orange, Rose, or Sugar Bowl. It's hard to complain about something that big time, because that is a big time bowl, and it's great. It's a great season to get to that game and win it. But we'll just have to see. We still have a chance of, you know, because LSU, they could beat Arkansas, but then they could go over here to the Georgia Dome and get beat. So there's a lot that can still happen, and I've got faith in the Crimson Tide, baby, of possibly getting up in the big show. So we'll just have to see how it goes, and that's about all I have for right now. I might come back and do another video if I have some time to do that, but as of right now, this is going to be it. And that's all I've got to say from down here on this rainy day in Birmingham, Alabama, and roll Tide, roll, baby.
Bye. Bye.